In this video, I show you a way to graph equations of lines if the equation is solved for y. For instance, graph y equals 2x minus 4. Keep in mind, one reason for graphing the line is that's a visual representation of all the ordered pairs that are solutions to that equation. All right, so what we can do is make up a little chart. We could pick a value for x and then figure out what y value goes along with that x. Now, there's an intermediate step which you may or may not need to do. I'm going to put the intermediate step in. Y is really 2x minus 4. So I'm going to show you how I get y. So, well, what can you put in for x? Any number you want. So, I usually pick a negative number, 0, and a positive number, but you could pick any number you want. So let's say we're going to plug in negative 1 for x, and then we'll plug in 0, and how about 1 and 2? It's true that you only need two ordered pairs to draw a straight line, but I suggest you do at least three to make sure that you haven't made a mistake. So if you've got 3 points on a line, that really will do it. A 4 is just an extra check. So what we're going to do is plug in negative 1 for x. So I'm going to have 2 times negative 1 minus 4, and I'm going to simplify that. So negative 2 minus 4 is negative 6. This is the ordered pair, negative 1, negative 6, for instance. All right, let's put in 0. So we put 2 times 0 minus 4. You have to be careful with your arithmetic, of course. That's 0 minus 4, which is negative 4. So we have another ordered pair, 0, negative 4. Now, if I didn't make any mistakes, then if I plot these 2 points and draw a line through them, that will be my graph. Let's just do 2 more for practice. This will be 2 minus 4, which is negative 2. I'm plugging in 2 for x. This gives me 4 minus 4, or 0. So I have 4 ordered pairs that I've shown. So our next step would be to take these 4 ordered pairs and plot them carefully on a graph, and then draw the straight line through them. Before going on, I want to point out that some people don't have to do that middle step. They simply write x, plug in negative 1, do it in their head, and write what the value of y is. And they've got these ordered pairs in this kind of a T chart. It's sort of like a T. Or some people simply just write the ordered pairs, put in negative 1, put it in their head, 2 times negative 1 minus 4, and write the ordered pair right next to it, instead of in a T-chart. So it's really up to you how you get these ordered pairs and how much work you need to show. But basically, we've got, whether we're looking at the T-chart or we're looking at these four ordered pairs, we want to plot those on the graph. So I want you to get out a piece of graph paper, carefully plot those points, get something straight, like a ruler, and draw the line through those points. Here are the 4 points. Next step is to draw a straight line. After carefully drawing a straight line, it doesn't hurt to pick some point that line goes through, as long as you graphed it carefully, and make sure it also makes the equation true. So I notice there's this other point right here, which is the ordered pair 2, 3, and convince yourself that if you put 2 for x and 3 for y, that would be 3, 2. That wouldn't have worked. 3, 2. If I put in 3 for x and 2 for y, is it true? So my original equation here, if I put in 3 for x and I put in 2 for y, I see that 2 is equal to 2 times 3, 6 minus 4. Yes, that's true. So this does give me the correct graph of that line. Let's go on to another equation, and this one has fractions. Okay, so that scares a lot of people off, but we could do this one just as easily. Now, remember, you could pick any number you want for x. So you could just put in 0, 1, and 2, for instance. But if you put in like 1 for x, you're going to have to deal with fractions and add, get common denominators, etc. So there's a trick to this, and that is since you could pick any number you want for x, pick something that's easy to plug in. Now, what's going to be easy? Some number that 3 is going to cancel with. You want that 3 in the denominator to cancel with something for x. That would be any multiple of 3, like 3, 6, 9, 12, etc. I'm going to pick a negative number, so I'll pick negative 3. I'm always plug in 0 because that's a super easy number to put in for x. And then how about positive 3? 3 order pairs is really all you need to put in. So let's do this. We're going to plug in negative 3 for x. Now, be very careful with your arithmetic here. You have a negative times a negative is a positive. And note, because I chose a multiple of 3, the 3 cancels here. So this is going to give me 2 plus 1. So my y value is going to be 3. The next one will be easy because any number times 0 is 0. So this gives me 0 plus 1, or 1. And then let's plug in positive 3. And again, the 3's are going to cancel. So I get negative 2 plus 1, which is negative 1. That's really all you need. You've got 3 ordered pairs, negative 3, 3, 0, 1, and 3, negative 1. So all we need to do is plot those 3 points on a graph and accurately draw a line through them. So go ahead and try that on your own, put it on pause, and then check it with the graph that I'll show. I've plotted the 3 points and I notice they're on a straight line. If they don't lie on a straight line, that means you made a mistake and just pick another value for x. So let's say one of those wasn't on the line. I computed y incorrectly. If I would just now plug in, let's say 6, hopefully I wouldn't make the mistake twice. I have negative 4 plus 1, that's negative 3. This gives you one more ordered pair, 6, negative 3. So if one of these dots was sort of off, hopefully you would see the 3 that are on the straight line. And now the last step is to simply draw a line through it. Remember to put the arrows on both ends of the line. So there's our line. Hope yours looks the same. Be as accurate as possible. Here's one more problem, y equals 1/2 x minus 3. So remember, we want to pick easy values for x because we could pick any number we want. So since the denominator is 2, that's what you're going to look at. You want multiples of whatever the denominator is, 2, 4, 6, etc. And you're always going to plug in 0. So I want you to plug in the values, let's say negative 2, 0, 2, and 4. And this middle step, writing out the steps, is just so you don't have to do the arithmetic in your head. But if you can do it in your head, that's fine. You just need to get the right y values. So go ahead, put it on pause, and let's see what you get for your y values. All right, here are the steps. We're plugging in the different values of x, and then be very careful with your arithmetic. So for instance, for this first one, you know it's going to be a negative minus 3, and you cancel the 2. So it's a negative 1 minus 3 is negative 4, etc. So the next step would be to put these 4 ordered pairs on a graph and then accurately graph the line through them. So try that. And this is the line going through those 4 ordered pairs. We notice they're on a straight line, so we get go ahead and draw that. All right, so we've done problems where it's solved for y. You're going to go on to the next video to see how to deal with problems if it's not solved for y. And I want you to make one more observation here. Notice in my x values, I kind of went up by 2's. From negative 2 to 0 is 2 spaces, and then from 0 to 2 is 2 spaces, and from 2 to 4 is 2 spaces. Check out what happened in the y values when I did that. This went up 1 space, right? Negative 4 plus 1. is negative 3. Add 1 again, I get negative 2. Add 1 again, I get negative 1. So this pattern actually continues. If you go up the same amount, some certain amount on the x values, like I was going up by 2s, the next one would be 6. This one's going up by 1. What do you think the next one's going to be? Add 1 to that, you get 0. That's only if you're going up by this constant amount on the x. All right, you're ready for lots of these. Practice them and then go on to the next video.